Welcome to Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. We have Chevy Impala here, 2005, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 2001. William and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. William and K, that the engine. This car have an issue. Where is that piece I give it to you? The piece, where is the piece? This car coming in with... Okay. This car coming in with no startability. It doesn't start, crank no start at all. The mechanic change, the crankshaft sensor change, the camshaft sensor, I believe. They change some stuff, I'm not sure. And after that, still the car doesn't want to start. We come, we diagnose the car. We found that this ignition control module computer was bad. After a diagnosis, the car spent with us here first day, second day. We check all the input and output of all the sensors, and we found that the ignition module, which drive the coils under the coils are here, and each output control two cylinders. Now we change it, the car start, but I see here we have a check engine light on. I don't know if this if we delete all the coils or we did not delete it at that time. But let's go ahead and scan this car. I'm using Snap-on Virus Edge. This is 2001. I should be able to read the VIN number automatically. So it is Chevrolet Impala. Chevrolet. This is from 1981 all the way to 2017. I did not upgrade it yet. Okay, now let's go. I like about this tool is that it have a lot of functions. I like it. One of the best functions, it has a scope in the back built-in. This is the scope. You can scope all the sensor. And also it has information about component test information. This is what I like about the Snap-on. Component test information, it tell you where the component location, what wire, ECM wiring diagram, they have it. And also it have if you get a code, you can click next and you look at like information input from all mechanics around the world. Okay, this car is 2001. I'm gonna look for 2001 here. And then automatic ID. Yeah, it's very fast. Do you want to load it? I say yes. 2001 Chevrolet Impala 3.8 liter. Now I'm gonna go to engine and transmission. Does it have an air pump with no air pump? I believe this car does not have air pump, no air pump. Code menu, display code, all powertrain code. Do I need all powertrain code? Yeah. Accelerator pedal circuit, circuit one. We have a code on accelerator pedal. Sensor one, circuit low. We have catalytic converter. We have TPS sensor and we have O2 sensors. Those are code that I have it here right now. Those code does have nothing to do with this one. But you already have TPS or APPS sensor, circuit one short low, and also catalytic converter P0 20 and P112, the same one with that one, TPS circuit low, and also O2 sensor, bank one sensor one, insufficient switching that this way. So we have those codes. Now let's go back and then see if we can get what we need again, if we can get any data display. What do you need on accelerator, electrical self-dent, no, ACC, no, engine data, fuel trim data, misfire data. Okay, EGR data, so let me go to engine data. TPS, you see here TPS and here TPS. Okay, let me try to see how it's working. This is O2 sensor, millivolt. You see a slow response, but I don't see O2 sensor 2. Okay, O2 sensor 2 millivolt, O2 sensor 1 millivolt. Okay, you see one of them is responding. Sensor 1 bank 1, sensor 2 bank 2, but one, this one here, O2 sensor 2 millivolt, O2 sensor 1 millivolt, one of them is responding very good, but this one here, this is O2 sensor 1, 2. Here you have to take some time and look where are those O2 sensors, because this car is supposed to have 4. But I see that one of them is like, let me give gas. I give gas, it start acting.
Let me go apart, please.
Okay, let me move this car now. What I need to do, I guess, I believe I have to delete the code first and then see if the code will come back again, repeat themselves. If the code repeat themselves, I'm not ready for getting exactly what I'm looking for, but here's the graphic, it shows us that how they are reading. Going to delete all these codes. I'm going to delete all these codes and then see, you know, sometimes it's responding, sometimes it's not. But let me get out of here. If you want to read those graphic, okay, you may need to get some time. You may need to get some time to choose what are you looking for. But I'm giving you the idea. How things are working. Let me see the fuel trims. That way, you can expose all the O2 sensors. You see, O2 sensor 1, O2 sensor 2. I supposed to get other sensors, unless this car have only one sensor by the catalytic converter for the two pipes, front and back. This is 2001. So, but what I'm getting also, let me go back. I don't want to do nothing now to get any decision, but I see code menu. I'm going to clear all this code. Let me display it first. Okay. Turn the key on. Go back. Go back again. Clear all these codes. And then we wait if when they come back. Display code again. All codes. I don't have no code now. I'm gonna start the car and see if they come back. We have to analyze this and then we see what happened. But right now we cannot take any decision based on what we see. Maybe they disconnected and they forget to put it back. Thank you for watching Mobile Electronic Diagnostic. This is Muhammad Idris. See you in another video. Please subscribe, share, and like, and see you in another video. Thank you.